Hello, today we are at Black Hat Europe 2019 in London in Excel venue, and together with Michael Grafnetter, I would like to talk about your talk, really, which you just finished in the Black Hat briefings. So what was the topic?
Yeah, it was about exploiting Windows Hello for Business.
Yeah, okay, so this is a passwordless authentication, yeah?
Yeah, it's one of the ways you can do passwordless authentication in Active Directory and in Azure Active Directory.
Awesome, so this is the way you can just forget about the passwords, which are made by the security experts as maybe a little bit obsolete, and maybe moving to something more advanced.
Yeah, really, because people forget their passwords, they tend to pick very, very simple passwords that are easy to guess, and when you see someone type a password, then you can retype it and hack into his account.
Yeah exactly. So, as I heard, you found a new vector of the attack combined with the multiple vulnerabilities. Tell me more about that.
Yes, so there are several different attack vectors against Windows Hello for Business. One of them was that if you register some devices with Active Directory and then you remove those devices, like an administrator removes these devices, let's say in a case when the device was stolen, then the authentication from that device still continues to work.
Okay. So you register really the device, or is it something bound with the device? How the mechanism work in the technical details there?
When you register a device with Windows Hello for Business in Active Directory or in Azure Active Directory, a set of keys, a public key and a private key are generated, and that private key is bound to the TPM chip in your notebook, and the public key is then written, registered in Active Directory database. And the thing is that when you remove either automatically or manually such device from Active Directory, this public key doesn't get deleted from Active Directory, it stays there unnoticed, and no one knows about it because it's quite hidden in the technical details of the stuff.
So how we detect this kind of technique of attacking or making a persistency in your Active Directory?
Well, I've actually created several PowerShell commands which you can use, and these commands are part of the DS internals, directory services internals PowerShell module on which I've already been working for quite some time.
Yeah, it's a quite well-known PowerShell module.
Thank you.
You can install it from the PowerShell gallery, very easy. DS internals, remember about that. And tell us more, where the disclosure was presented to the Microsoft, how you came up with this idea even? How was the timeline there?
Yeah, well, I started playing with this technology like a year ago, and then I really gave it some time, probably too much time during the last summer. So you know what I did last summer, right? And I discovered several things by studying documentation, reverse engineering stuff, and doing some experiments with this, some trial and error stuff. Of course, I found many other attack vectors which were not possible actually, but you know, you learn by doing mistakes. And of course, when I was finished with my research, I reported my findings to Microsoft, and they reacted to that. They confirmed two of my findings actually, and they have released an advisory yesterday, the day before Black Hat, advising their customers how to deal with these security issues.
Okay, so do they present as well how you should react for it, what you should do it in? Are there any PowerShell scripts presented by Microsoft as well?
Yeah, they have created their own tool, which actually works similarly to my own tool, which I created before them. But their tool is, of course, supported by Microsoft, and it can also be used to audit Active Directory for these issues. and to mitigate them those issues, to delete those vulnerable keys from Active Directory or those keys that simply shouldn't be there. But the thing is that it's not just an update that you apply to Windows and you forget about it. You really need to follow this guideline. You need to check your Active Directory and you need to actively mitigate those issues.
Okay, is it something reported in the event log that you can monitor for on your SIEM solution? How to do it?
Well, some things are reported in event logs, like when your TPM chip generates and uses weak keys, it is put into local logs, which you have to collect, of course, and analyze on a centralized SIEM solution. If you have such solution,
yeah.
if you're not monitoring events, then you're blind, and there are many things an attacker could do, and you can stay oblivious to all those things.
Okay, to get everything right here. So there's a new vector of attack combining a couple of vulnerabilities related to the Windows Hello for Business and storing the public key and the certificate inside of the Active Directory for the users, allowing us to authenticate even if user is changing the password?
Yeah, that's another attack vector. If you get some non-trivial permissions to Active Directory, then you can pretend that you are registering a device for this specific user, and you can generate your own public-private key pair, not in a TPM, but just in a file on your computer. You register this public key with a specific user account in Active Directory, and the corresponding private key can then be used instead of a password. And that persists even after password changes. So many companies, when they have suspicions that they've been hacked, one of the things they might do is resetting passwords to all those accounts, right? But even if they do this futile thing, this is a persistent stuff that will still stay there. The password change doesn't delete those public keys that are registered with user account. You have to modify your processes and you have to account for these findings, for these keys.
Okay, so just to be clear, you are not changing your position and about the passwordless authentication, are you?
No, I think that it is really good, and it probably is the future of authentication, and many companies are really pushing it forward. It's not just Microsoft, but also Google and some other cloud companies. But with all technologies, you need to use them responsibly, and you need to know what to look for, what security issues to look for, how to audit the usage of all those technologies. And if you know what you are doing, then great.
Okay, thank you for the interview. It was awesome talk, and hope to see more of those on the Black Hat. Tomorrow you have as well another thing. You are presenting the DS Internals PowerShell module. So if you don't know this one, remember to check it out.
Thank you, and thank you, Mike. Goodbye.
Bye.